Let's go and talk about an included angle. So if I have an included angle, what an included angle means is an angle between two sides. All right? So we always talked about our side-side-side congruence. But now if we have side-angle-side, Malik, what that tells us is we have side-angle-side. So here is two examples of included angles. The reason why we call them included angles is because the angles are in between the two sides. Okay, so you have to know that included angles are in between those two sides. Now, where it gets a little difficult for this is let's pretend, let's do another triangle. And let's try to see if they're congruent by side angle side. So let's do side angle side. Or let's do I do side angle side. Okay? So ladies and gentlemen, these two angles are not, or these two triangles are not congruent. Remember, if it's going to be side angle side, now these two have two sides, right? And let's say these two are equal. Right? It has two sides and it has an angle. You could say side, angle, side. Right? And you could say side, angle, side. Correct? Can you not say that? Yes. Just like we did here. Side, angle, side, side, angle, side. But do you notice how these are so nice and tight to each other? Right? Your angle is in between the two sides. So these are what we call included angles. Here, if I was going to do side, angle, side, I do side. I skip this angle, skip this side, and then I go to that angle. Well, therefore, you're skipping all those. It's not going to be included. Therefore, this is not, you cannot prove this with side angle side. You can also not go side angle side. All right, you can't skip over your angle if you're going to do a side angle side. You can't skip over another angle to try to do it. All right, so these would not be included angles. So therefore, these would not be side angle side. It's very important, Megan, that you guys make sure you know, understand the difference with that. Okay? So that's with your included angle.